सो लास्ट डे वी हैड सीन द ब्रांचेस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड क्वालिटेटिव कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अकाउंटिंग इंफॉर्मेशन एंड वन बेसिक अकाउंटिंग टर्म्स. ओके, let me ask some questions. What are the qualitative characteristics of accounting information? What are the qualitative characteristics of accounting information? Hanna Salim, tell the answer. Qualitative characteristics of accounting information.
Reliability,
Reliability.
relevance,
Relevance.
understandability,
Understandability, comparability. So next, what are the branches of accounting? Aparna, what are the branches of accounting?
So financial accounting,
financial accounting,
cost accounting,
cost accounting,
and management accounting,
and management accounting. Then what do you mean by financial accounting, Karthik? What do you mean by financial accounting?
Sir, the main purpose of financial accounting is to ascertain the profit or loss by calculating the profit on by making the profit and loss account.
Yes. Then
and present the financial position of the business by preparing a balance sheet.
Okay. Next, sir, what do you mean by cost accounting? Anuj, what do you mean by cost accounting? Sharats, what do you mean by cost accounting?
The purpose of cost accounting is to find the total expenditure and also find the cost of various products.
Okay, to ascertain the total cost and per unit cost of goods produced. So what do you mean by management accounting? What do you mean by management accounting, Anjo? What do you mean by management accounting?
To plan operations of business.
To assist the management in planning and controlling the operations of management. For that purpose only, we are using management accounting. So today I am going to start a new accounting terms. That is, the name of the topic is, the name of the accounting term is assets. So what do you mean by assets? Assets means anything which is in the possessions or is the property of the business, including the amount due to it from others. That is assets. Assets means anything which is in the possessions or is the property of the business, including the amount due to it from others. That is assets. Otherwise, anything which enables a business to get a cash or a benefit in the future. That is assets. Example, cash in hand, cash at bank, debtors. If example, if we sold goods on credit to any person, so we will get that amount in future. That is also our assets. Otherwise, building, furniture, land, motorcycle, car. These are the examples of assets. Means anything which is in the possessions or is the property of the business and including the amount due to it from others. That means debtor. Debtor is a person who owes some amount to the business. That is debtor. That is the due to it from others, including the amount due to it from others, means debtor. that is assets. Okay, so the assets can be classified into two type: fixed assets and current assets. Fixed assets and current assets. So what do you mean by fixed assets? What do you mean by fixed assets? Fixed assets are those assets which can be acquired for a relatively long period of time and are not meant for resale. That is fixed asset. Are those assets which are acquired for relatively long period of time and are not meant for resale. Means these assets helps in the generation of income. These assets helps in future. Such assets are known as fixed assets. What are the examples of fixed assets? Anyone? Karthik? Examples of fixed assets? Any? Fixed assets.
I don't know, sir.
Okay. So, a example is building, land, furniture, machinery. Okay. So, these are the fixed assets. So, these are the assets which are acquired for relatively long period of time. So, if you use the machinery, then we will get benefit in future. So, such assets are known as fixed assets. Then, fixed assets are again classified into tangible assets, intangible assets, wasting assets, and fictitious assets. And fictitious assets. Okay. It is classified into tangible assets, intangible assets, wasting assets, and fictitious assets. So what do you mean by tangible assets? So tangible assets are those assets which can be seen and touched. So such assets are known as tangible assets. Okay? Tangible assets are those assets which can be seen and touched. Assets having definite shape and physical existence. Such assets are known as tangible assets. Example: land, building, machinery, furniture, motor car. Such assets are known as tangible assets. Next, second one is intangible assets. What do you mean by intangible assets? Intangible assets are those assets which cannot be seen and touched. They have no physical existence. So such a type of assets are known as intangible assets. It is represented by the rights. It is represented by the rights in certain things. Example: goodwill, patent, copyright, trademark. So these are the intangible assets. So it is represented by the rights in certain things. So such a type of assets are known as intangible assets. Okay. So next one is wasting assets. What do you mean by wasting assets? Asset which get exhausted due to extraction. Asset which get exhausted due to the extent of extraction. So such a type of assets are known as wasting assets. Example, mines, quarries, oil fields. If you extract, the amount of assets will decrease. So such a type of assets are known as wasting assets. Last one is fictitious assets. Fictitious assets. Fictitious asset means assets have no real value but are shown in the books of accounts as an asset.
Just give me.
Okay, so such a type of asset is known as fictitious asset. Asset have no real value but shown in the books of account as an asset. Why we are recording as an asset? For right of purpose. From upcoming year, from profit and loss account, we will write off that assets. Example, preliminary expenses. Preliminary expenses. Next, discount on issue of shares. Discount on issue of shares. So such type of assets are known as fictitious assets. It is really expense only, but we are writing in the books as an asset because in the upcoming year, we will write off these expenses. Assets have no real value, but shown in the books of account as an asset. That is fictitious assets. Okay, so I said fixed assets. What do you mean by fixed assets? Fixed assets are those assets which can be acquired for a relatively long period of time and are not meant for resale. Example, furniture, machinery, land, building, plant. Examples. Then fixed assets are again classified into tangible assets. Tangible assets are those assets which can be seen and touched. Next, intangible assets. Example of tangible assets, furniture, building, machinery, plant. Then intangible assets. Intangible assets are those assets which cannot be seen and touched. Assets having no physical existence. It is represented by rights in certain things. Goodwill, patent, right to exclude others from making, selling, using a particular product. That is patent. Then what do you mean by copyright? The exclusive right to publish, display. That is copyright. What do you mean by trademark? Prevent others from using a particular name. Okay? That is intangible assets. Next, wasting asset. What do you mean by wasting asset? Asset which get exhausted due to the extent of extraction. Mines, quarries, oil fields. Next, fictitious assets. Asset having no real value but shown in the accounts as an asset. That is fictitious assets. Then the upcoming year, we will write off these expenses from profit and loss account. For write-off purpose only, we are writing as fictitious assets in balance sheet. So next one, liabilities. And next one more classification is the current assets. Assets are classified into fixed assets and current assets. Then from that, what do you mean by current assets? Current assets are those assets which can be easily converted into cash. Otherwise, assets which are held for a short period of time. Such type of assets are known as current assets. Example of current assets. Cash in hand, assets which are held for a short period of time. Cash at bank. Next, debtors. Next example, debtors. What do you mean by debtor? Debtor is a person who owes some amount to the business. Suppose if we are a firm, if we sold goods on credit to any person, that person is a debtor. So we will get that amount within a short period of time, within a year. So such a type of assets are known as current assets. Okay, cash in hand, cash at bank, debtor. So such a type of assets are known as current assets. Okay, next one is liabilities. What do you mean by liabilities? Liabilities refers to the amount which a business owes to others, either for money borrowed or for goods and services purchased on credit. That is liabilities. Liabilities refers to the amount which a business owes to others, either for money borrowed or for goods and services purchased on credit. That is liabilities. Okay, so liabilities are again classified into long-term liabilities and short-term liabilities. Liabilities are again classified into long-term liabilities and short-term liabilities. What do you mean by long-term liabilities? Otherwise, fixed liabilities. Already I said, fixed assets are classified into, assets are classified into fixed assets and current assets. Likewise, liabilities are classified into long-term liabilities and short-term liabilities. So what do you mean by long-term liabilities? So long-term liabilities are those liabilities which are payable after a long period of time. Such type of liabilities are known as long-term liabilities. Liabilities which are payable after a long period of time. That is long-term liabilities. Example, loan, debenture. Debenture means we give a loan to any company. Suppose in an organization point of view, we took a loan from the public. That is debenture. So if the firm took a loan from the bank, if it firm took a loan from the public, that is our long-term liabilities. Liabilities which are payable after a long period of time. So such liabilities are known as long-term liabilities. Next, second one is current liabilities or short-term liabilities. Current liabilities or short-term liabilities. So what do you mean by current liabilities or short-term liabilities? Liabilities which are payable within a short period of time. Liabilities which are payable within a short period of time. Such type of liabilities are known as current liabilities. Example, creditors. Suppose if the firm purchased goods on credit from any supplier, so the supplier is known as creditor. Okay, creditor. Next, one more example, outstanding expenses. So what do you mean by outstanding expenses? Expenses which has become payable this year, but not paid. It is this year expense, but still we didn't pay that expense. Example, outstanding salary. Suppose this year we have to pay 24,000 as salary, but if the firm given only 20,000, so that 4,000 is outstanding expenses. This is our current liability, because these liabilities which are payable within a year. So such liabilities are known as current liabilities. Okay, so I said the liabilities. What do you mean by liabilities? Liabilities refers to the amount which a business owes to others, either for money borrowed or for goods and services purchased on credit. That is liabilities. So liabilities are classified into long-term liabilities and short-term liabilities. So what do you mean by long-term liabilities? Liabilities which are payable after a long period of time. That is long-term liabilities. Example, loan debenture. Next, current liabilities. So current liabilities are those liabilities which are payable within a short period of time. Example, creditors, outstanding expenses. So next our basic term is capital. What do you mean by capital? Capital refers to the money or money's worth invested by the owner into the business is known as capital. Money or money's worth invested by the owner into the business is known as capital. So starting time, if the owner invested any amount, otherwise owner invested any goods, otherwise owner invested any machinery into the business is known as capital. Amount, it refers to the amount invested by the owner into the business is known as capital. Otherwise, it is the excess of assets over liabilities. Excess of assets over liabilities. That is also capital. Capital is equal to assets. If the firm have more assets than liabilities, that represents capitals. It is given to the owners. Capital. Amount, money or money's worth invested by the owner into the business is known as capital. Okay, otherwise it is the excess of assets over liabilities. That is capital. So next one is drawings. Drawings. What do you mean by drawings? Drawings refers to the money or money's worth withdrawn by the owner for his personal use. Amount of cash or other assets withdrawn by the owner for his personal use. That is drawings. Suppose they took amount from the business for their personal purpose, for purchase of any items for their home, for purchasing LED for their home. That is drawings. It is the amount of cash or assets withdrawn by the owner for his personal purpose, not for office purpose, for his personal purpose. That is drawings. So So next one is revenue. Next word, revenue. Revenue represents the amount the business gets through the sale of goods or by providing services to the customer. That is revenue. Revenue represents the amount the business gets through the sale of goods or providing services to the consumer. That amount is known as revenue. Example, sale. Sale is the major revenue of the business. Sale is the major revenue of the business. Revenue represents the amount the business gets through the sale of goods or providing services to the customers. That amount is known as revenue. So sale is the major revenue. Other revenues that are there, interest received. If you invest any amount in the bank, we will get interest. That is a revenue. Commission received, rent received. If we given our building as rent basis, we get a rent. That is also a revenue. Dividend received. If we invest any amount in the share, then we will get dividend. That is also our revenue. Okay, so revenue represents the amount the business gets through the sale of goods and by providing goods and services to the customer is known as revenue. Okay, so next one is expenses. Expenses. What do you mean by expenses? Expenses refers to the cost incurred in producing and selling goods and services. That is expenses. The cost incurred in producing and selling the goods and services. That is expenses. Cost incurred in producing and selling goods and services. Example, cost of goods sold, salary, rent paid. If it is a rented building, we have to pay rent. Office expenses. Selling expenses. Interest paid. If we took a loan from the bank. So these are the expenses. Lot of expenses. Wage paid. Commission paid, advertisement. These are the expenses. Means expenses incurred in producing and selling the goods and services. That is expenses. Clear? Any doubt? So first I taught assets. What do you mean by assets? Assets are the properties or the possession of a business, including the amount due to it from others. Including the amount due to it from others means debtor. Okay, assets are classified into fixed assets and current assets. What do you mean by fixed assets? Assets which are acquired for relatively long period of time and are not meant for resale. Then what do you buy current assets? Current assets are those assets which can be easily converted into cash. Otherwise, assets which are held for a short period of time. Next, I taught liabilities. What do you buy liabilities? Liabilities refers to the amount which a business owes to others, which a business owes to others, either for money borrowed or for goods and services purchased on credit. Next, I said liabilities are classified into long-term liabilities and short-term liabilities. What do you mean by long-term liabilities? Long-term liabilities are those liabilities which are payable after a long period of time. Then what do you mean by short-term liabilities? The liabilities which are payable within a year. Okay? Next, I taught what do you mean by capital. Capital refers to the money or money's worth, cash or other assets invested by the owner into the business. That is known as capital. So otherwise, it is the excess of assets over liabilities. Next, I said liabilities. Next, drawings. Drawings refers to the amount of cash or other assets withdrawn by the owner for his personal use. For giving treat to our family, we took amount from the business. That is drawings. Okay. Next, revenue represents the amount the business gets through the sale of goods or providing services to the customers. What we are receiving, that full everything, it is revenue. Next, expenses. What do you mean by expenses? The cost incurred in producing and selling goods and services. That is expenses. Okay. Next, profit. So what do you mean by profit? Profit is the excess of revenue over expenses in an accounting period. That is profit. So already we know what do you mean by revenue? What do you mean by expenses? So what do you mean by profit? It is the excess of revenue over expenses in an accounting period. That is known as profit. It is the excess of revenue over expenses. That is profit. So what do you mean by loss? Anyone? Just the opposite of profit. Anyone? Hannah, what do you mean by loss? It is the excess of anyone?
Expenses over revenue.
Yes, it is the excess of expenses over revenue in an accounting period. It is the excess of expenses over revenue in an accounting year is known as loss. Next, income. So what do you mean by income? So income is different from revenue. Why? So income means profit. Income is profit. Amount received from the sale of goods is called revenue. And the cost of goods sold is called expenses. But surplus of revenue over expense is known as income. So income is equal to revenue minus expenses. Same like profit, income. Income is different from revenue. Suppose sold goods amount is rupees. Suppose cost of goods sold 4 lakh. Cost of goods sold 4 lakh. We sold for rupees 5 lakh. Then amount, the amount of income is equal to 1 lakh. Okay, cost of goods sold is equal to 4 lakh. The sold amount is 5 lakh. So the amount of income, the amount of profit is 1 lakh. That is income. Okay. So today I taught assets. So what do you mean by assets? Anything which is in the possession or is the property of business, including the amount due to it from others, that is assets. Example, I said cash in hand, cash at bank, debtors, furniture, machinery, plant, land and building. These are the assets. So assets are classified into fixed assets and current assets. Fixed assets are those assets which are accrued for relatively long period of time and are not meant for resale. Example, furniture, machinery, plant and machinery, car. So these are the examples of fixed assets. Then what do you mean by current assets? Current assets are those assets which are held for a short period. Otherwise, these assets which are accrued, which can be easily converted into cash, are those assets which can be easily converted into cash. Example, cash in hand, cash at bank, debtors. Then we can tell accrued income. Accrued income. Accrued incomes are those income. Really, this is this year income which are not got. Suppose if we invest any amount in the bank. Suppose we invested, the firm invested 1 lakh in the firm. So 10% is interest. So we have to get how much amount? 10,000. But we got only 8,000. So that 2,000 is accrued income. That is asset, current assets. Then one more assets I can tell, prepaid expenses. Prepaid expenses means expenses paid in advance. Next year expenses, but we paid this year. That is our current assets. Suppose prepaid insurance. Next year insurance, we paid this year. That is our current assets. So I said, what are the example of current assets? Cash in hand, cash at bank, debtors, bills receivable. Bills receivable, extra I'm telling, bills receivable, same like debtors, bills receivable, accrued income, that is current assets. Okay, next I taught liabilities. What do you mean by liabilities? Liabilities refers to the amount which a business owes to others, either for money borrowed or for goods and services purchased on credit, that is liability. So liabilities are classified into long-term liabilities, the liabilities which are payable after a long period of time. Example, loan, debenture. If you took a loan from bank, that is loan. If you took a loan from the public, that is debenture. That is, this is our long-term liabilities. Next one is current liabilities. Liabilities which are payable within a year. Example, creditors. If you purchased goods on credit from supplier, that is creditor. Then bills payable, it is related with the bill, creditor, same. Then outstanding expense, this year expense we not paid. Example, I said outstanding salary, that is our current liabilities. Next I can tell income received in advance. Income received in advance, commission received in advance, rent received in advance, next year income only, but we received this year. But it is a liability because next year if anything happened, we have to return that money. So that's why it is a current liability. You have to write income received in advance. Example, rent received in advance. That is our current liabilities. Okay? So today's class is over. So next day, I will teach the remaining basic accounting terms and I can start the next chapter. Okay? So you have to study these basic accounting terms. Thank you all. Have a nice day.